Good day children, Sai Ram. In today's class of English composition, we are going to continue with paragraph writing. In our previous class, we had seen a few examples on how to write a paragraph. In today's class, we will be seeing a few more examples on how to write a paragraph. But before that, let us quickly revise what we had learned about paragraph writing in our previous class. Let us first understand what is a paragraph. A paragraph is a number of sentences grouped together which relates to one topic. Children, I have already told you that a paragraph contains a number of sentences, and all the sentences describe one topic, one idea, or one thought. A paragraph usually describes a noun or an event. A paragraph may describe a person, a place, an animal, a thing, or a festival, or a month, or any day of the week, or any other noun. It may even describe an event. An event may be any event like birthday celebration, marriage ceremony, sports event, annual function, or any other celebrations. Rules to be followed while writing a paragraph. Children, rules are very important which you need to follow while writing a paragraph. So let us see what are the rules to be followed while writing a paragraph. Read the given sentences at least 3 times. Children, in grade 3, you will be given sentences in the form of points. All the sentences will be jumbled. You have to read the given sentences at least 3 times and understand them. Don't be in a hurry. Take your own time and read all the sentences carefully and understand them properly. Find out the topic sentence from the given sentences. The second step will be to find out the topic sentence from the given sentences. Once you find out the topic sentence from the given sentences, it would be easy for you to arrange the other supporting sentences in order of their importance or in order of the actions that are happening. Arrange the supporting sentences in a sequence. As I already told you, the supporting sentences should be arranged in order of their importance. Or if a paragraph is describing an event, then the sequence will be according to the actions that are happening. While writing a paragraph, the sentences should follow one another. That is, all the sentences should follow one another. You should not leave any lines or any space in between 2 sentences. Do not write the paragraph in points. This is the common mistake made by students. The paragraph should not be written in points. All the sentences should follow one another. The first sentence of a paragraph should be indented. Children, in other words, when you are writing a paragraph, you should not start the first sentence from the margin. See children, this is the margin. You should not begin the first sentence from the margin. You should leave 2 finger space from the margin, and then you will start writing the first sentence of the paragraph. That is, you will not start the first sentence from the margin. You will leave 2 fingers space, and then you will start writing the first sentence of your paragraph. The rest of the sentence will start from the margin. Okay children, so the first sentence of a paragraph should be indented. That means you will leave 2 finger space and then start the first sentence of your paragraph. The rest of the sentences will start from the margin. Begin all the sentences with a capital letter. Children, you must have learnt in grammar also that a sentence should always begin with a capital letter. This is very important. Don't begin a sentence with small letter. Begin all the sentences with a capital letter. Give a suitable title to your paragraph. Once you find out the topic sentence from the given sentences, it will be easy for you to find a suitable title to your paragraph. So children, now let us understand how to write a paragraph in a better way with the help of the following example. Arrange the sentences to form a meaningful paragraph. Give a suitable title to the paragraph. Children, I will be giving you the sentences. The sentences are in jumbled form. You have to read all the sentences how many times? Yes, 3 times. You remember the rule? Read all the sentences at least 3 times. So you will read all the sentences 3 times. Then you will find out the topic sentence, and then you will arrange the other supporting sentences to form a meaningful paragraph. So children, now let us start. They are suitable for almost any home. It is easy to take care of them. Fishes serve as great pets. It is said that watching fishes swim in water can reduce our stress level. They don't occupy much space in our house. They are cheaper than other pets. They are kept in tanks. Children, let us read these sentences the second time. They are suitable for almost any home. It is easy to take care of them. Fishes serve as great pets. It is said that watching fishes swim in water can reduce our stress level. They don't occupy much space in our house. They are cheaper than other pets. They are kept in tanks. Children, now the third time. They are suitable for almost any home. It is easy to take care of them. Fishes serve as great pets. It is said that watching fishes swim in water can reduce our stress level. They don't occupy much space in our house. They are cheaper than other pets. They are kept in tanks. Children, we read the given sentences 3 times. So now can you identify the topic sentence from the given sentences? Which sentence according to you describes the topic to which our paragraph is related? Yes children, very good. Fishes serve as great pets. This is our topic sentence. It describes a noun. And which is the noun? Yes, fishes. So, fishes serve as great pets is our first sentence and it is the topic sentence. The other sentences are supporting sentences. So, now let us arrange them in the proper order. Fishes serve as great pets. Why do you feel that fishes serve as great pets? Why not other pets like cats or dogs? Yes, because they are suitable for almost any home. That is, the size of your home does not matter. Whatever may be the size of your house, you can easily keep fishes. That is why we say that fishes serve as great pets. So, the second sentence will be, they are suitable for almost any home. This sentence will follow the topic sentence. Okay, why do you feel that they are suitable for almost any home? Yes, because they don't occupy much space in our house. Unlike other pets like dogs and cats, fishes don't occupy much space in our house. So this will follow the second sentence. Okay, children? Why do you feel that they don't occupy much space in our house? Yes, because they are kept in tanks. Because they are kept in tanks, they don't occupy much space in our house. So, they are kept in tanks will be our fourth sentence. Children, now three sentences are remaining. It is easy to take care of them. It is said that watching fishes swim in water can reduce our stress level and they are cheaper than other pets. The sentence, it is said that watching fishes swim in water can reduce our stress level, is a concluding sentence. That is, it will be the last sentence of our paragraph. The remaining two sentences, that is, it is easy to take care of them and they are cheaper than other pets. They can be arranged in any order. You can arrange, it is easy to take care of them first, and then they are cheaper than other pets second. You can exchange the order of these two sentences. Any order will be okay. Now, the last sentence will be, it is said that watching fishes swim in water can reduce our stress level. So, this will be the seventh sentence. So, children, we have arranged all the sentences in order of their importance. So, now our paragraph is ready. So, this is how our final paragraph will look. We have given a suitable title to our paragraph, Fishes as Pets. You can see that from the margin, I have left two fingers space and then started the first sentence of my paragraph. Fishes serve as great pets. They are suitable for almost any home. They don't occupy much space in our house. They are kept in tanks. They are cheaper than other pets. It is easy to take care of them. It is said that watching fishes swim can reduce our stress level. Children, can we read this paragraph once again? Fishes as pets. Fishes serve as great pets. They are suitable for almost any home. They don't occupy much space in our house. They are kept in tanks. They are cheaper than other pets. It is easy to take care of them. It is said that watching fishes swim can reduce our stress level. Children, here you can see the sentences, the beginning of the sentences is written in capital letter. Okay, so you have to begin all the sentences with capital letter. So children, I hope you have understood how to write a paragraph. So now let us see one more example. Arrange the sentences to form a meaningful paragraph. Give a suitable title to the paragraph. We all sang the birthday song. The living room was decorated with colorful balloons. The cake was a large chocolate cake. She had invited many of her friends. As a return gift, she gave us a set of books. Anna celebrated her 10th birthday yesterday. There were 10 candles on the cake. Anna blew the candles and cut the cake. Children, now let us read the given sentences the second time. We all sang the birthday song. The living room was decorated with colorful balloons. The cake was a large chocolate cake. She had invited many of her friends. As a return gift, she gave us a set of books. Anna celebrated her 10th birthday yesterday. There were 10 candles on the cake. Anna blew the candles and cut the cake. Now the third time, children. We all sang the birthday song. The living room was decorated with colorful balloons. The cake was a large chocolate cake. She had invited many of her friends. As a return gift, she gave us a set of books. Anna celebrated her 10th birthday yesterday. There were 10 candles on the cake. Anna blew the candles and cut the cake. Children, after reading all the given sentences, what do you feel? Are there any sentences describing a noun? No, none of the sentences here describe a noun. All the sentences describe an event. What event are they describing? Yes, they are describing a birthday party. Whose birthday party it is? Yes, it is Anna's birthday party. So children, can you find out the topic sentence from the given sentences? Yes, very good. Anna celebrated her 10th birthday yesterday. This is our topic sentence and hence it will be the first sentence of our topic. The other sentences are supporting sentences. Now, because it is an event, you have to arrange the sentences in order of the actions that are happening. Okay, children? So, we found out the topic sentence. Now, let us arrange the other sentences. So, children, which sentence will follow the topic sentence now? Yes, she had invited many of her friends. So, this sentence will follow the topic sentence. Okay, so the second sentence is, she had invited many of her friends. Okay, now, which will be the third sentence? Yes, the living room was decorated with colorful balloons. This will be the third sentence. Okay, after that, which sentence will follow? Okay, now comes in the birthday cake. So, the cake was a large chocolate cake. This will be the fourth sentence. Okay, what you can see on the cake? Yes, there were 10 candles on the cake. This will be our fifth sentence. After that, what happened? Yes, Anna blew the candles and cut the cake. This will be the sixth sentence. After that, what happened? Yes, we all sang the birthday song. This is the seventh sentence. And the last sentence will be, as a return gift, she gave us a set of books. Okay, because return gift is given at the end of the birthday party. So children, now we have arranged all the sentences in proper order. Can you give a suitable title to this paragraph? Yes, Anna's birthday party. So children, now let us read our final paragraph. Can you see how the final paragraph looks? Okay, I have left 2 finger space from the margin before writing the first sentence of the paragraph, and the other sentences will start from the margin. Anna's birthday party. Anna celebrated her 10th birthday yesterday. She had invited many of her friends. The living room was decorated with colorful balloons. The cake was a large chocolate cake. There were 10 candles on the cake. Anna blew the candles and cut the cake. We all sang the birthday song. As a return gift, she gave us a set of books. Let us read this paragraph once again. Anna's birthday party. Anna celebrated her 10th birthday yesterday. She had invited many of her friends. The living room was decorated with colorful balloons. The cake was a large chocolate cake. There were 10 candles on the cake. Anna blew the candles and cut the cake. We all sang the birthday song. As a return gift, she gave us a set of books. Children, I hope you have understood how to write a paragraph, how to find out the topic sentence, and how to arrange the supporting sentences to form a meaningful paragraph, and also how to give a suitable title to your paragraph. So children, I will take your leave now. In the next class, we will see a few more examples on paragraph writing. Till then, bye. Sairam.